Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we're diving into the exciting new release of Kali Linux 2024.2. This version is packed with updates, new tools and some important changes under the hood. Whether you're a cybersecurity professional, a hobbyist or just curious about Kali Linux, there's something here for you. So, let's get started. First up, let's talk about the biggest change in this release, the transition to T64. Now, you may be wondering, what is T64? Well, it's all about future-proofing our systems. In simple terms, T64 is a new way of handling time in our computers. The current system, called TimeT, will run into a big problem in the year 2038, because it can't handle days beyond that. This is known as the year 2038 problem, similar to Y2K issues from the year 2000. To fix this, the size of TimeT is being changed from 32-bit to 64-bit on some systems. For Kali Linux, this mainly affects 32-bit ARM architectures, like those used in Raspberry Pi devices. By making this change, we're making sure our system won't crash or have errors in 2038. So, what does this mean for you? If you're running Kali on a 32-bit ARM device, you'll need to use the command apt-full-upgrade instead of just apt-upgrade when you update your system. This ensures everything transitions smoothly. For most users on standard 64-bit system, you'll just see a lot of package updates, but everything should work as usual. Next up, let's talk about the desktop environment changes. Kali Linux 2024.2 brings us the latest GNOME 46. This version offers a more polished experience with updated themes and extensions. Everything looks sleeker and works better. The GNOME desktop environment gets updated roughly every 6 months. With GNOME 46, you get smoother animations, improved performance and more intuitive interface. It's all about making your experience better and more efficient. But GNOME isn't the only desktop environment getting some love. The XFCE desktop has also received updates, specifically for Kali Undercover and High DPI modes. This update brings better stability and fixes several minor bugs. So, whether you prefer GNOME or XFCE, this release has something for you. Now, let's dive into the new tools added in Kali Linux 2024.2. Every Kali release includes new tools, and this one is no different. We've got 18 new tools this time, thanks to the amazing contribution from the community. Here are some highlights. AutoRecon, a multi-threader network reconnaissance tool great for automating your network scans. Coercer, this tool automatically coerces a Windows server to authenticate on an arbitrary machine. Dplot, a Python rewrite of Sharp DPIP useful for data protection API attacks. Getsploit, a command line utility for searching and downloading exploits. GoWitness, a web screenshot utility using Chrome headless, perfect for capturing web pages. And that's just a few of them. There are also tools for monitoring processes, payload generation, and even some fun ones like accessing the Wayback Machine API using Python. With these new tools, Kali continues to be the go-to platform for cybersecurity professionals. Whether you're performing penetration tests, vulnerability assessments, or any other security tasks, these tools will be incredibly useful. Let's move on to the kernel and other miscellaneous updates. The latest kernel, version 6.8, will be available shortly after this release. It's worth noting that during testing, a bug was found in kernel 6.6 that could cause slow downloads and crashes when using certain virtualization software. This has been fixed in the new kernel. Another cool update is with Nmap, a network scanning tool. You can now run privileged TCP/CYN scans without using sudo or being root. This makes scanning easier and more efficient. For those of you using Kali NetHunter, there are some exciting updates here too. NetHunter now supports Android 14, includes a new module loader, and has various improvements in permissions and root validations. Plus, there are 5 new NetHunter kernel covering devices like the Huawei P9, Nothing Phone 1 and Poco F3. These updates make NetHunter even more powerful for mobile penetration testing and other security tasks on the go. Kali on ARM single board computers like Raspberry Pi has also received some updates. The Gateworks new port kernel has been updated to 5.15 and the Raspberry Pi 5 kernel to 6.1.77. Unfortunately, support for Gateworks Ventana has been dropped, but they're always looking to improve and support as many devices as possible. Lastly, the Kali documentation has seen several updates. This includes new guides and updates pages for AVC, fixing dual boot issues, installing NVIDIA GPU drivers, setting up VirtualBox and VMware, and more. This makes it easier for everyone to get started and troubleshoot any issues they may encounter. So there you have it, Kali Linux 2024.2 is packed with new features, tools and improvements. Whether you're upgrading for a previous version or installing Kali for the first time, you're in for a treat. Remember, for a smooth upgrade, use the command apt-update and apt-full-upgrade. And as always, if you find this video useful, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you for joining me and I'll see you in the next one.